Welcome to the Prayer Motivator Devotional Broadcast with Daniel White III. We are glad that you have joined us as Daniel White III encourages us to pray without ceasing throughout the day, every day, for the glory of God.
Good morning and welcome to another Prayer Motivator Devotional Broadcast. Today, I would like to begin by sharing with you a poem titled, There is Never a Day That We Should Not Pray. Allow me to repeat that. There is never a day that we should not pray. By Andrew Adams. Give us this day our daily bread, and bless those, O Lord, whom have not been fed. I thank God for my food, and I can honestly say there is never a day that we should not pray. If not for ourselves, there are plenty in need of hope and compassion. Is their hearts we must feed. The light of God can show us the way. There is never a day that we should not pray. He gave us His Son, who taught us to share, to love and forgive. He taught us to care, for He died on the cross, and for our sins He did pay. There is never a day that we should not pray. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that's one of the most beautiful poems that you will ever hear, impregnated with great truth for all of us. And this is so true. Even though the devil will tempt you not to pray, there is never a day that we should not pray. If you have been listening to our broadcast for a while, you know that the main purpose of this simple broadcast is to motivate, to encourage, and to exhort you to pray. I am convinced that most people do not need to learn how to pray, especially most Christians. They need to just pray. If I can get you to just pray, all sorts of wonderful things will begin to happen for you, your family, and whatever God has called you to do. We do not pray based upon our feelings. We pray based upon biblical facts. Our thought for today is that prayer is a result of having godliness in our lives. Yes, God is working through the power of His Holy Spirit to motivate us and to help us to pray. There's some godliness or some God working in our souls, in our hearts, in our minds, in our spirits that moves us to pray. For the devil is not going to encourage you to pray, and your sinful flesh is not going to encourage you to pray, and the world is not going to encourage you to pray. Our prayer motivator quote for today is from William Carey. He said, prayer, secret, fervent, believing prayer, lies at the root of all personal godliness. Our prayer motivator quote, verse for today from the Word of God is Luke 22:41, which reads, and He was withdrawn from them about a stone's cast, talking about Jesus Christ, and He kneeled down and prayed. Our Lord was a praying man. Our prayer motivator devotional for today is that prayer takes time. Prayer takes time. From the prince of prayer, a modern day prince of prayer, J. Gordon Henry. Investing the needed time to pray effectively is necessary. Now, tomorrow morning is the National Day of Prayer, and here in America, and we're going to do something special on tomorrow, so please make sure you're with us on tomorrow as we talk about prayer and a nation. Time. It takes time to pray, and this is one of the reasons why many people in our busy society today do not pray. There are three background areas that need a word here. J. Gordon Henry says, we will deal with the first one now. First, prayer takes time. Prayer takes time. You cannot rush this thing, and you cannot rush God. During the past few days, I have been impressed with the necessity of investing the needed time to pray effectively. Somehow it is imperative that we understand that we will never be effective prayer warriors when we spend 10 minutes in prayer and 3 hours watching a baseball game. Somebody ought to say amen right there. Unless there is willingness to set aside quality time for intercession, for prayer, we will most likely make little difference as a prayer warrior. While it is true that everyone has as much time as anyone else, one of the subtle tactics of Satan is to assure us that we are too busy to spend much time in prayer. Allow me to repeat that. Please get this. While it is true that everyone has as much time as anyone else, one of the subtle tactics of Satan is to assure us that we are too busy to spend much time in prayer. The amount of time we allow for prayer is an index of the real importance we attach to prayer. Some of us have become so engrossed on majoring on the minors that there is little time left for really important matters such as prayer. Now, you ought to just say amen right there. We're going to pray. We're going to take some time to pray right now. Now, remember, dear friend, the announcer will provide the information for you to send in your prayer requests. At the end of this broadcast, we do not take any prayer requests over the phone. We take all of our prayer requests via email. So feel free to email us your prayer requests. We get hundreds of emailed prayer requests. And we pray for each person by name each day until they tell us to stop or they send in a praise report that the prayer has been answered. Now, friend, please join me in prayer. Holy Father God, we praise you and we thank you for your love, your mercy, and your grace. We thank you for the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ that has washed away our sins. We confess our everyday sins on an individual basis unto you. Forgive us, Lord, for Jesus Christ's sake, of all of our sins, whatever they might be. As we, by your grace, forgive others who have sinned against us. And Lord, have others to forgive us. And Lord, we pray that you would crucify our flesh and the old man within us all as your Christian people, and fill us with thine Holy Spirit that we may walk in the power of your Holy Spirit throughout this day. We pray for your leadership, guidance, and direction in all that we do and say. We include in this prayer all who listen to us regularly and those who are just listening for the first time. And Holy Father God, as we have just been reminded, help us to take our time. Help each of us to take quality time, Lord, in prayer, and effectively pray to you. We pray also that you would bless and guide all pastors, church leaders, and missionaries around the world to stand for you in these last days, and who are these people who are truly helping people in ministry. Lord, give them your grace and strength and the power of your Holy Spirit to continue to do that. Holy Father God, we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We pray also that you would truly save and give leadership, guidance, direction, and wisdom to the president and all of the governmental officials who run this country, that we may lead peaceful lives. We pray these blessings upon all national leaders around the world. Holy Father God, we also pray now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for some dear people who have emailed in for prayer through our ministry, Gospel Light Society International. And we count it a joy to pray for them and their needs. It is a privilege to do so, and you have even blessed us tremendously for doing so, and we thank you for that. Lord, we pray for Christina. Give her a word for her life. Lord, I pray that you would encourage her heart today. Lord, deliver her from the doldrums of depression, and Lord, help her to live out the meaning of her name, Christina. Grant her your grace and your anointing and the power of your Holy Spirit to be a shining light and to be the witness that you want her to be. Lord, help her to see the power in helping others, and how that when you help others and pray for others, your depression will go away. We plead the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ against Satan, who's working against her. And Holy Father God, we pray for Deborah. Bless her with financial security. And Lord, help Deborah to realize that her security must be in you. And Lord, we also pray now for Darlene. Deliver her family members from their addiction to alcohol. And Lord, we pray that you would help Darlene to be the Christian that you want her to be. And Holy Father God, we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now we pray for the following people who have accepted you into their hearts. We pray, Lord, that you would confirm them in the faith and have them to grow in the faith to become the spirit-filled Christians that you want them to be. Lord, we pray specifically that you would encourage the hearts of Patricia in Arlington, Texas, Bella Nira in Mexico, Blanca in Ecuador. Thank you, Lord, for saving these people. Thank you for using us here at Gospel Light Society International to play a small part in getting these people saved. Lord, as I was talking with two of my oldest children on yesterday, Lord, you heard the conversation, how that we talked about how your word is so true. The harvest is white, and the fields are white under harvest, but the laborers are few. There's so many millions of folks who are just ready to get saved, But so many Christians are not willing to go out into the field and reap the harvest. Holy Father God, for Jesus Christ's sake, please forgive us of our sins of not being willing to reap the harvest for you. Holy Father God, we pray now for all of the people who have recommitted their lives to you through our ministry here. And we pray that you would help them to keep their commitments to you. We pray for Manny in Tucson, Arizona. We pray for Colleen in Canada. And we pray for Angelita in Mexico. Lord, we thank you so much for this privilege of prayer. Thank you for giving us a mind to take time to pray. And Lord, we pray that all of our listeners would take the time to pray today and every day of their lives. In Jesus Christ's name we do pray, and for his sake. Amen. Now, in closing, dear friend, if you are listening to this broadcast and you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior, please notice these verses from the Holy Word of God. Romans 10:9 and 10:13. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Now, dear friends, you can bank on this. You can count on this. This is the Word of God. This is the way to get saved. I am the chief of sinners, and if God can save me, he can save you. You can count on this. This happened to me over 30 years ago, and I'm serving the Lord now more than ever and love him more than ever, and he will save your soul as well. If you want to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ today, if you would like to put your faith in him for your salvation, if you're willing to trust Christ as your Savior today, please pray with me the following prayer. Heavenly Father, I realize that I am a sinner. For Jesus Christ's sake, please forgive me of my sins. I now believe with all of my heart that Jesus Christ died, was buried, and rose again. Lord Jesus, please come into my heart and save my soul and change my life forever. Amen. Now, dear friend, if you have accepted Jesus Christ into your heart today as your Lord and Savior, please contact us today so that we can send you a free copy of our pamphlet titled What to Do After You Enter Through the Door. This will help you get started in your Christian life. Until then, remember, dear friend, pray, thank, do. God bless you.